Good afternoon, fellow countrymen. This is Sendil Kumar, IIF Chennai Chapter Secretary. Before we get started, I request all the participants put yourself mute and also switch off your camera. And if you have any queries, maybe end of the session, you can ask the queries, either unmute yourself or you can also put it in the chat box. It gives me immense pleasure in interacting with you for yet another webinar in our non-ferrous series. And as you all aware, the Chennai chapter is conducting on weekly basis seminar on every week, and we keep third week or fourth week for our non-ferrous subject. And we are into our this month non-ferrous session. To get things started, now I request Mr. V.K. Raman, IIF Chennai chapter chairman, to welcome the gathering, please. Chairman,
okay,
sir.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, thank you, Sendil.
Yeah.
It's our immense pleasure to welcome you all for this wonderful webinar to be presented by Mr. Subhendu, who is Solution Manager in Fosecure India Limited. He is going to touch upon predominantly on crucibles and flow controls, where the efficiency can be enhanced to the optimum level, which will be helpful to all fellow foundrymen. So once again, I welcome all the fellow countrymen and our today's speaker, Mr. Subhendu Day, and request everyone to raise the questions at the end of the program so that the speaker will be in a position to give answers. So once again, welcome you all. Now I request our Secretary Sendil to take further. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So I would like to thank in first itself Mr. Fosico. They have been supporting us for all these technical seminars, and as of all aware that Fosico, what kind of the technology they have, and they have readily accepted, and then they have accepted to give a presentation through Mr. Subhendu. And to formally introduce the speaker, I request now our council member Ms. Hema Prasad to give introduce the speaker, please.
Thank you, Sandhu sir. So it's my pleasure to introduce today's speaker, Mr. Subhendu. He then is Bachelor of Engineering from Indian Institute of Science and Technology, Shibur, and he continued his studies in postgraduate diploma in Business Administration from ISPA Business School, Kolkata. He worked in Tata Steel, Vesuvius India, and then Fosico India at various capacities, starting from quality, production, and sales. He worked almost last 16 years in non-ferrous foundries, marketing crucible, and various range of refractories. He also worked in ferrous foundries and including integrated steel plant for 13 years. Now it's floor for you, Subhendu. Thank you.
Thanks, Chairman IIF Chapter Chennai, Ramanji, Senthilji, and all the members of the IIF Chapter, and the distinguished audience who have were giving their time for me. In fact, I am honored to have this facility to speak on crucible for a couple of minutes. So let me start with sharing my presentations, and at the end, whatever query you will have, I would try to respond to the best of my understanding. And let's move on, and I'm sharing. Anything we do from Fosico, we don't believe that you supply just that product. So our concept of solution partnering comes. The problem may not remain only in crucible or maybe in one area. That is why we call solution partnering. And then the topic that has been kept today is the efficiency of the foundries through crucible. How can a foundry get it? We will discuss that. Now, if you look at the contents, some of the contents I will pass through with very little explanation, because those may not be highly required. The areas where you will have a active, very much interest on those, I'll give you more time on that. And first, I have kept the areas where the efficiency will be available, and obviously the talk is more enough. The always the effort is how to get that efficiency, and to get that efficiency, what are the things to be done and where are the areas? This time, although I have given extensive range, but primarily you'd be talking about the crucible care and the stance, usage, significance, what are the normal thumb rules that's come into play to get the efficiency. And finally, we will talk the fluxes, because I don't believe the crucible chapter or the crucible discussion is not complete until you discuss the flux. That is the, I would say, the most important part as on day. So let me show, this is just a beginning, because maybe some of our audiences may not be knowing FOSICO, they know very well, but may not be knowing when the FOSICO had started the business, like in Vesuvius. In 1916, they actually started the Vesuvius Crucible Company, it was. And then gradually over a period of time, they have made about four plants, including four continents. And that is how we are in India, having a manufacturing facility from 2003. Now, if I talk about where and how the crucible can improve efficiency, the first thing that comes, the metal quality. You will remember before 2010, there were many technical seminars or projects were also being seen to replace crucible as the melting or holding pot. Some people are going for the line furnaces or the refractory line furnaces. But then gradually people understood that there is an inherent benefit in the metal quality, which may not be 100% true in case of the line refractory. That is why when a person uses the crucible for melting or the holding, the non-metallic inclusion part is almost absent. At least I have not seen any scanning electron microanalysis of the castings where I have seen that the ingredients or the from the crucible it has gone into the metal. I have not seen so far. And then the other things that we talk about, foundry per se, people don't look at it that it's a big unit like integrated steel plant. No, there is a, it's a little smaller in concept although, but having a big foundry is not bad. So here the benefit is that secondary operations of the melting, if I talk about aluminium, customers or our users, what they do is they melt the aluminium in a bigger furnace, either tower melting or maybe I think there is another furnace which is oil-fired. I forget his name. I will tell you later on. Then the subsequent operations before casting, they do it in a secondary way where the crucibles are widely used, especially in HVDC. And in a GDC, okay, people use both melting and holding, and in LPDC also. And if you even go to the other section of the usage of this crucible, like brass, aluminium, brass, copper, different alloys, there it is more used as a mostly gas-fired or a oil-fired. Now, when you talk about quality in an aluminium, obviously, you cannot be silent on the H2 pickup. Now, here, when you use crucibles, I think that has a role, and minimizing that, it helps. If you look at the metal holding cost and electric resistance furnace, most of our customer knows when they calculate that the cost of uses one crucible per kg or per ton of metal melting, it's a very, very minimum. In kg, it comes just few paisa. So the cost is very minimum. And when it goes into the metal recovery, the customers or the different foundries, they use different kinds of granular fluxes, and they the recovery of the metal they get very well. If you talk about crucibles, one of the things that really is very good, that somehow our industry or foundries, there sometimes ups and downs goes on. The demands of the castings from January to December or even April to March, it is not uniform. So sometimes the load is low and sometimes the load is very high. But when you use a crucible, you have a flexibility that if I have a 10 furnaces, I do not have load, I may run only 5 furnaces. But otherwise thinking, if you have a big lined furnaces, you could easily realize the shutting down one furnace and with the 50 line is little costlier than this. And finally, all of you understand that since the capital expenditure for putting a furnace, electric resistance furnace, or even a oil-fired, gas-fired furnace is not very high, so it doesn't affect the cash flow of the business or the company. Now, those are the areas where people get what their customer gets satisfied. Like if their customer gets a good metal quality, they will be very satisfied. If the foundry, they see that they are able to meet the demands of the customer by using or optimizing their resources, like the limited way, whenever they can use the crucible. So those are the areas where this is an opportunity cost. If you compare crucible vis-a-vis the other ways like refractory furnaces, even if you compare today's silicon carbide crucible versus some people were using few years back this cast iron crucible, there also you will see that when they use a silicon carbide crucibles, the ferric component does not come and the quality is good. So in essence, the metal quality, the holding cost, the efficiency, the minimum shutdown, these are very, very minimum. And as a result, the cash flow is also maintained. So those are the areas that we find, the areas where actually it matters. Then when we come the life of the crucible, then when a person starts using a crucible, he will go for extensive use of the crucible. Every foundry has a design of experiment, like they will put the crucible and they will see how much their life goes on, and then they will make a standard operating practice. Now, in the measurement of the life of the crucible, what are the things that are very important? One is the crucible selection, because this is when a foundry thinks about castings, he will be thinking about his metal output per shift or per day, and then depending upon that, he will choose a electric resistance furnace, say suppose 37 kilowatt or a 40 kilowatt or 56 kilowatt or even 25 kilowatts. So he will be deciding that first, and then they will be taking accordingly the crucible. So although they go for the capex of the furnaces, but that time only they already thought about what kind of crucible they will be using. Is it 700 millimeter dia, or is it 800 millimeter dia, or is it 750 millimeter height, or even a 900 millimeter height? I remember in India, first time in 2003, in Sundaram Clayton, 1 ton crucibles we had given. So that time also, the selection was very important. Their objective of the end customer and what the foundry wanted to give. So in the crucible selection, in the life of the crucible, you will see the selection is important. Then it has to be the furnace parameter and the operational parameter. Now here is a very a little complex, because you see, if everyone knows that a ship is very safe in the harbor, you know, but then the ship is not meant to be stayed in the harbor. Like an aeroplane is very safe when it is grounded in an airport, but it is not meant to stay in the airport. It should always fly. Similarly, crucible, it is not meant to be in a cool furnaces, so it has to run in the furnaces. That is why the furnace parameters and the operational parameters has a very, very significant role to get the best of the life. And if I say who knows the best, obviously we work with each of the customers whenever we get an opportunity. But obviously the person, even the operator of the furnaces, he knows the best during the period. Obviously, nowadays, everything can be improved once he starts measuring and also starts getting learning. So it is not that the operator is remains at his learning base. As time goes on, he also increases his knowledge base. In India, we have seen the average life in an HVDC furnace, or even a GDC is little less. We have seen a life of 4 to 6 months on average. But I have also seen that every foundry, they put a standard operating practice. Somebody puts 3 months, somebody even puts 7 months. But I have not seen more than 7 months, or max 8 months. But then whoever sets it 8 months, but there that the SOP is not eight. They extend the life till such time it fails. Then comes the standard operating practices that I have talked. Why standard operating practice? Because standard operating practice has a strong effect or significance on the thermal shock creation and mechanical load. Now, here the question will come, what is thermal shock? Now, I think people will get to know in a normal life, especially even at Chennai, in a summer time, if you are sitting in an AC which is 18 degrees centigrade, and then you suddenly go out in the sun, which is 47, 46, or even 45, you will feel a little difference. The kind of disease, or I would say that time, is that sunstroke. People call it in a normal parlance. Similarly, in case of crucible also, if there is a difference of temperature from one point to another point, a very high steep gradient, then the thermal shock gets created. Thermal shock is nothing but a load gets created between the two points when there is a significant difference. And significant means, I would say it is more than 6 to 10 degrees I have seen. But then there is no very meticulous measurement at every point of the crucible from the top to the bottom. That is why in future days, there will be a lot of work on these areas, that how to minimize that, or what can be done that way. Then there is different people or different, the industry per se is working on the crucible which will have the thermal shock resistance higher. Now it is measured. Is it measured by normally the somebody calls the modulus of rupture at room temperature, or even the modulus of rupture at 800 degrees centigrade or 1000 degrees centigrade. Some people may call it a transverse breaking load, but whatever it is a load that gets generated because of the change of temperature. Now then, if you go, you will see the flux. Now in HVDC, the effect is little low, but if you go to the GDC, even if you go to alloying, like those people who are using the crucibles for the melting, a little dross which is decontaminated, and even the people who are making the utensils with the bigger crucibles, they are after 10 days or 15 days, if you see the crucible, you will see there is a dross layer built up at the top. And that is a source of issues or challenges. And there, customer has already seen, when they use a good quality granular flux, this dross sticks goes down. Because what we came to know from different customers who are using sometimes Fosico fluxes, granular fluxes, because it creates a dry dross, it could not travel to the generation point, to the edges of the crucible. Because if when it goes into the edges, it sticks to the crucible wall. And if it sticks to the crucible wall, and if it is not clean, then subsequently it gets built up. Because once it hardened, it's very difficult to remove. So here the question comes that how can you best maintain, not only from the cleaning point of view, but also from the insulating point of view, but also from the capacity point of view. So those are areas where it helps to get a better life of the crucible. Now, there's another point which is important. That is, I remember when we discussed with one of the customer, and I don't know whether some of you will be agree with me also, that after the weekend, people are actually scared to start the furnace because they don't know or which crucible will get cracked. And then the gray areas will come, that why it is cracked and why it is this after this weekly op. But in general, tendency is restarting a furnace requires some amount of precaution. And if we take precaution, the chances of getting the crucible in the restarting of the furnace goes down. It may not be 100% or it may not be zero, but it is significantly reduced if the operators and the different people in the shop floor, they are made aware that this is the problem comes during the weekend, and this is where we have to work. So this point could be easily taken care of. And last, that maintenance of the crucible, which is meant that during the running of the furnace, we should be taking a proper maintenance in terms of even the running of the coils. Like you have a heating element and you are maintaining a temperature, a certain temperature, let's say 670 or 680, or those who makes about 740, 750. Then if something happens in some coil, then those areas will not get hit. And there, the chances of lower temperature prevails. And because of this, the oxidation of the crucible starts. I will talk about oxidation later on. And but this is a point. If the technology comes exactly where the element is not working properly, if it can found out, then the chances of having a better maintenance of the furnace is better. So these are the different ways by maintaining of which we can increase the life of the crucible. Although part by part, if you see the effect, it can be quantified. Somewhere it may not be quantified, but other places it can be quantified. And people can see there are customers who over the period of 1 year, they see how many times they get a shutdown or unprecedented breakdown because of the crucible. And if it is not, they are very happy, because that is the objective of each of the foundries. They want a complete running. If they have a full load, even if they do not have a full load, they should not have a breakdown, because nowadays crucible, with the different raw material prices and other things, the cost is really high. So these are the areas where I believe that if we work well, it will be good. Then comes the energy saving. Now, this is not very predominant in India, but in the coming days, this will be an important one, because a crucible for a period of time, if it takes, say, 6 months and say 500 kg crucible, to my understanding, if I am not wrong, customers spend about 4 to 5 lakhs or even more worth of energy. Now imagine if anyone can reduce this by few percentage, it's another crucible. So obviously, that now the we take a lot of time working on some of the customers where we are generating some kind of a data and then proving it, that how one of our brands are started giving a better energy savings. So finally, if you take crucible, flux and furnace, and if you see the savings calculations, you will see it goes about 6 to 7% or 6 to 9% of the crucible benefit. Now here I have tried to show, now we have shown the life of the crucible, what are the things that we do so that the life gets increased. But then for a customer, once the crucible actually reaches to his premises or her premises, the clock starts. That means the handling of crucible is very important. And where it starts? The moment they get it from the truck, that is unloading of the truck, and how that will be unloaded, how it will be kept, those all things are there. Here one or two things will be important, that in none of the times we should keep crucibles on the floor, because it's a hygroscopic material, and if you use hygroscopic material, it picks up moisture, and if it picks moisture, then it gives subsequent problems. Those are the first point. And the second point, in case of any kind of a premature failure, if the boxes are given, this is specific to Fossico, if these box numbers are given, internally we can track down and we can find out the manufacturing history cards. And on addition to this, no one should be allowed to roll out or to roll the crucible in the floor, because it's actually disturbs the glaze. That is the most important part in a crucible which is to be used in aluminium. Now I come to a schematic diagram, and this is not meant maybe for this audience. This I propose to be printed and kept in the station where the crucibles are kept, or to the maintenance place where the maintenance person gives a lot of time. Because everywhere it is given that what is to be done and what is not to be done. In a way, this is a little schematic diagram for the proper uses of a crucible, right from the inspection of the crucible till to the crucible cleaning it has been given. One of the things that I must tell you that even in this technology today, whatever we have, there are very less amount of non-destructive test. There are batches, samples, control plans, everything is there. But then the if a crucible you want to test, then a full crucible has to be destroyed and then testing has to be done. Because there is no other technology as a moment which is commercially viable for that. Then I come to the crucible selection, and here since I am talking from the Foskikos platform and through IIF, I would give a kind of a some parameters. If these are taken care of, most of the things are taken care of in the selection. One is the furnace type, then the kilowatt or of the furnaces, because some of the time we have seen, or I would say that after 2007 or 2008, there is a every foundry, like they want to have a continuous improvement. So they want to run the furnaces at lower kilowatts. Obviously, the energy consumption goes down. So once the kilowatt goes down, then what will have its effect on the crucible, that you will also come to know. That is why this kilowatt is very important, not only from the throughput point of view, or production point of view, or even his demand satisfaction point of view to his customers or her customer, but is also, I have seen the effect on the crucible. And lower the kilowatts, higher is the tendency for the oxidation. Then you have to choose a different kind of a crucible. Like for your, okay, it is out of the track in entire Chennai, whatever crucible we sell, Some of our customers takes crucible which is Duratec ER. This is a very good crucible when you talk about the top oxidation. And that is the area where each and every foundry with a electric resistance furnace is having an issue. So there we have seen that Duratec ER performs very well because it has got an antioxidant at the top which is 200 times more than the normal crucible, Turcotte crucibles. So that is why we have given this kilowatt. Then if we talk about the utensils or even the alloy manufacturer, they use the high capacity crucible with a normal gas fired furnaces, and gas pressure and the nozzle sizes are very, very important for them. Nozzle cleaning is an important part. Then dimension of the crucible is an important part. Temperature is the mother, because if anywhere anything fails and if we don't get the temperature, it will have no meaning. Like the investigation is incomplete unless you get the temperature range. Some of the customers, they are measuring continuously the temperature. Most of the customer, they measure in a batch process, like they put a thermocouple and then get the temperature. But maybe your customers like pushing down that they want to know the continuous temperature from the day one to the last, and the expected operating practice in the shop floor, that also is a measure. Because when you take the history or even the normal life of each and every customer, we find some of the customers stand out. Even in Chennai, some of the customers, they continuously get 6 months. some of the customer, they get 4 months. So when people ask that what is the life, you will not be able to say that this is the life. You can maximum say under standard operating practices, you can get this life, but there is no sanity of that data, because the moment you put into a thermal recycling, your lot of variables comes into practice, which people know of. It is not that people do not know, but then it matters. And then if we go to the next part, where I have talked about the preheating and certain rules. These images which I have given is a real image. It has happened to some of our customers. I will not explain the preheating time because if people know, stand basically to be used only for to take the load of the metal as well as that of crucible and distribute it. That is the purpose of the stand. And then its conductivity should not be different from the crucible. Now, crucible, if you ask me, our crucible is having a conductivity of about 18 to 20 watt meter Kelvin. So if you take a castable, which is about say 40% alumina or even 50% alumina, even 60% alumina, they don't have that amount of conductivity. So if you do, if you don't have the conductivity well or doesn't match with the crucible, then the problem comes. Like the last image, where if you see this one, what happens? They have put into a castable stand, and the moment they did a preheating, there is a bursting took place because there are a lot of moisture content in the castable and it did not evaporate. So that was a point. And then this crucible also, that they have used a stand and some furnaces where the heat was not reaching. As a result, this area has been completely oxidized. And if you see the bottom is not put on a stand. You can see the impression of different material. Now, this is a study which we have done, and many customer also does it, but on the assumption that if you do not, if you use a fiber blanket on the top of a stand and below the crucible, nothing happens. It's like a cigarette and cancer. Like if you give 10 millimeter and if everything does well, the conductivity and everything does well, it may not be having a problem, but that does not mean that it actually destroys the crucible. We have seen and we have proved that if you use 30 to 60 millimeter fiber, it genuinely creates a problem. And it is not that if you use a 10 millimeter fiber, it will not having a problem, because this fiber is having a conductivity of 0.6, 0.7, not even 1 conductivity of watt meter Kelvin. Normally they have 0.5 to 0.9 watt meter Kelvin. So that is the reason we say that never use a fiber, use graphite flexes and material which will not stick to the crucible, because sometime the glaze of the crucible runs down and gets sticked. So that is why some amount of material or even cardboard carton boxes you can keep, it works well. This is a study that has been plotted and seen. This we gave an example, like think about if you have a 1 kg load, and if I ask you that you hold it at your hand for 1 minute, you say not a problem. If I say you 5 minutes, then you say not a problem. But if I tell you that you hold it for 10 minutes, you will say now it's a stress. So anything load for a continuous period of time, if you give, it will create stress. That is given, that is why it is shown in the red color. The moment you keep the blanket and heat does not go off and then it creates a thermal stress, and finally it cracks the bottom. So that is the reason, if you see, when you use a different kind of a fiber, you will have a different kind of stress and it kills the crucible. So this is a very important point. And if we take care, you will see the result of it maybe after 8 months or 9 months, because some amount of data should be generated by that time, and you will see a good result. Even in a crucible, in a full year, if you get one failure, and if you don't use crucible fiber for the whole of the year, you will see your cost is justified. So that is why we say that don't use any kind of a ceramic blanket on the top of the stand. Here are certain rules. These rules are little thumb rules, and most of the installation people or the maintenance people, they know it. These are the rules: using a proper stand, conductive stand, gap of the ring, because if you don't keep a wrong ring, you will get a crack at the top. And it happens even today. Few days back, we got a complaint where the top was happening. The issue is, on the top of the crucible, when you pack a ceramic blanket, and that ceramic blanket, if you take from five sources, if their compaction is not same, then you may get a desired, you may not get the desired result. That is why you say be careful on this. It should not be tightly packed. I know that this has been given so that any kind of a metal sprinkler, they doesn't reach into the coil and damages the coil. The objective is very, very noble and it's right one, but we also have to see that it will give certain amount of space to the top so that the expansion of the crucible is accommodated. Rest we have given what should be the furnace inside dia and the outside dia of the crucible gap. Normal thumb rule is 10%. Now, if it is 790 millimeter, theoretically it is 79, but practically it is seen that even if you keep 65, it is okay. So this kind of guidance, when you use in respective foundries, the SOP automatically gets generated by the CR practice and the data. So these are the things that we have seen, that issues come up and what are the rules is there, and these are the recommendations. So I would say even till today, since some of our manufacturers, some of the marketers or manufacturers of the crucible, they are selling crucible with an unfired glaze, which means you need to have a 8 hours minimum firing. But whatever Fusico supplies is the fired glaze, so you don't require so much heating time. So you will be able to do that in a very easy manner. Now, common causes, I came down from the efficiency part, the factors that have given you efficiency or that are likely to give efficiency, the factors that are likely to give a higher life of the crucible, then the factors, those are very common. And if we arrest those, then that creates some kind of a precautions, where if we take care of the uses and the benefits are good enough. In this whole broad four categories, this mechanical damage, thermal shock, and chemical attack, the last one is very important. If you see the preheating cycle, you will see when the temperature is 400 to 500, the gradient is very high. It means that during this temperature, the oxidation or the carbon burning or the graphite burning inside the crucible very fast. That is why these zones, we have to be careful that as fast as we can cross this range, we have to attain 750, because the glaze that we has been given to protect the crucible from low temperature has to be melted, remelted. So this is one point which we have to keep. The race things, I think you are aware of it, so I am not in going detail. So in the mechanical portion, these are some of the things we give for a at least for understanding, or if you go deep into the subject, then you will find these are the things happen. Now, there is one thing that very common. These are the things you can also justify, or you can also validate from your respective foundries whether it happens or not. In a gas-fired furnace, whether the cover bricks or grip bricks, it can sometimes give you problem crack. And in a tilting furnace, if your crucible is tight and the spout is very tight, there also you will see there is a there is no expansion gap getting in. As a result, the problems are appearing in the spout zone area. This is one. I think this is one of the last few slides where this is become very prominent nowadays, because there are reasons for it. Today, you all of the foundries are almost aware the minimum amount of precautions, like stands, like pre-heatings, like no amount of mechanical load. Those have become very common, unless by accident these happen. But apart from that, there is another issue that is building up, is this dross buildup. And this is quite important. The analysis at the lab says, if you keep a dross inside the crucible and if you go on heating, obviously that heat will not be passed on because of the insulating nature of the dross. So the generation of the dross, although it is not 100% full of your control generation, but built up to the wall, it is absolutely in your control. So the effect is the metal loss, the conductivity of the crucible, the chances of crack due to differential of expansion, because it is told that the expansion of the dross and the expansion of the metal, these are two different, widely different, very wide different. One is the metal, another is the, it's a aggregates, or I would say a mix of different sizes of materials. Then the dross needs to be cleaned. So that is why if it is not clean, it will have a problem in the maintenance of the crucible. So as soon as the dross gets generated and stick to the wall, we must clean it so that you will not see the reduction of the capacity. We will not see the different expansion, and you will not see the heating is different and the chances of oxidations are very, very less. Recently, a few studies we have done whereby we have seen that when it is used Fossico crucible and the fluxes, the savings are coming between 4 to 9%. couple of studies have been done, but then it is not complete. We have to do more study before we generalize and go back to our customer and say, you could adopt it so that the maximum life and without any danger, because life is one thing, but another thing is, suppose if you have an unprecedented breakdown, I understand that stress you go because you have to clean it. Restarting the furnace is very, very time consuming and unplanned. This is in addition to the cost. So we have talked about the one of these toolkit that this coverall and the coverall 88 for the cleaning and the dry dross is for the, or the granular fluxes is the GR, coverall GR. And then you get the best of the life. I think I have covered most of the things because if we go at the end, we have shown crucibles. You use a flux, you use a cleaning flux, and you get the EVC. Of course, here I must say, if you don't get the EVC or economic value creation through usage of this, why should a customer be used? But we have seen in a couple of customers that these are getting useful. I think I have done my whatever I wanted to convey to you. Now I am ready for taking question because I believe whatever I show, I think I have shown to the maximum whatever we can do through the use of crucible, the efficiency to the foundry men. And it is over to you. Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Participants, any clarification, any doubts? I think Mr. Prabhakaran, sir, raised his hand. Mr. Prabhakaran, sir.
Yeah, I have a couple of questions. One is related to the gap.
Yes.
The thumb rule is 10% we are saying. If we give more gap, is there a possibility of loss of energy?
You are 100% right, Rohan sir. 100% right that the thumb rule is 10%, but if you see, I had told that is why that suppose in case of BUC 500, normally the top dia is 785. So thumb rule comes about 78 millimeter. So that is why I have said if you keep 65 even plus, if you see that you are getting a good heating, you are not getting a problem, your standard operating practice should be 65. But in the name of that reducing of that gap, when somebody keeps 30 millimeter, 40 millimeter, some of the time I have seen that people it fails. It results into a crack.
Another question is the raw materials, whatever is used, silicon carbide, graphite, and everything, it's all conductive in nature. Sometimes, in some cases, a new crucible has conductivity issue. It is not conducting, that is, it conducts, but takes a longer time to heat to achieve the required temperature. How come this is possible?
See, what happens, the conductivity of a crucible depends on 5-6 parameter. Obviously, it starts from the raw material, then the bond structure, then the crystallinity, then some other factors, glazing factor. So it is not 1+1 formula, but what you are saying, I also have observed, but this has been observed in more of a coke-fired furnaces, where I tested some of the crucible, we tested some of the crucible, and my advice to you will be, try to see whether it is creating an insulating layer at the outside of the crucible because of the different gases you generate through the gas-fired furnace or a coke-fired furnace?
Sir, this is not a coke-fired or gas-fired furnace. It is an electrical furnace where normally the melting happens in 2-2.5 hours. Sometimes it takes more time to melt. In the initial, it's not a... I'm talking about a new crucible. This is the case of a new crucible.
Okay, then it maybe could be the issue that when in manufacturing of the crucible, the glaze is given. Now, this glaze has to be remelted in the previous preheating till 750 degree temperature. So if you don't raise to the 750 and then half an hour soaking, if you give, I believe the problem will come less. You can try out. We got an example. We tested it in some of the cases, but the conductivity of that piece did not come lower. So we took it as that the heating medium, insulating medium, or the glaze maturity in that particular crucible because of some operations in the manufacturing.
Sir, any other doubts from any of the participants?
Hello.
Yes, sir, you can Hello. Ask.
Sir, yes. What is the minimum size of the crucible available?
You will be melting what metal?
Like cast iron.
See, cast iron is having a temperature of 1300 plus. So, okay. What we talked about is silicon carbide crucible. I would not tell you that use it, but maximum temperature 1250. Some of the cases I've seen, one or two heats you might get, but this is not the best in class material for cast iron.
So do you have any other like type of crucibles which can stand temperature up to 1500?
1500, you have to use then alumina crucible, which is not manufactured in India.
Okay, sir.
If you want to use like investment casting, they use about 1700, 1800. They use alumina crucibles. They can't use silicon carbide for this high temperature.
Okay, sir.
Hello. Sir, hope no any doubts about the participants. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Subhanji. So thank you for sharing your valuable thoughts related to increasing the efficiency and crucible. So once again, I thank all the participants for attending this session and getting the inputs. So likewise, IAF Chennai chapter is conducting webinars on ferrous and non-ferrous on every Saturday afternoon in the 2:30 to 4. So we are sharing that information to all the participating industries. So kindly attend and getting the inputs. So thank you all once again for joining this webinar. Thank you all.
Thank you, IAF chapter. And thanks also to Fusco for getting this platform. Thanks. Thanks yourself.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.